with these above average temperatures, flooding still a major concern today.
Yeah, Crime 2's Whitney Ward is keeping track of the flooding that's going on across the area. Whitney.
Good afternoon. Yeah, the situation basically right now is still getting worse instead of better. Governor Jay Inslee declared a state of emergency in both Ferry and Okanogan counties. The Okanogan River is expected to gradually continue to rise over the next several days. Experts say it may not recede until early next week. Okanogan County Emergency Management shared this video again of the flooding near Tenasket. Right now, the Okanogan River is closed to all recreational activities. That's an order directly from the sheriff. That means no boating, no swimming, or anything else on the river until further notice. And there will be an informational meeting tonight for people living in Okanogan County. That will take place at 6 at Okanogan High School in the Dawson Gym. Local officials as well as emergency management workers will all be available there to answer questions as well as provide an update on the river activity. Now, the Kettle River in Ferry County also expected to keep rising. It is expected to be at 20 feet by the end of today. It doesn't get much better for the rest of the week. Record flooding forecast for the river crests on Saturday. Nearly 200 DNR firefighters are helping with the flooding in both Okanogan and Ferry counties tonight. They've been filling sand bags just trying to divert that water flow. Some people near the Canadian border right now are without clean water. Authorities are just asking them to boil the water just in case as a precaution while they make sure that nothing upstream is contaminating the water supply. In the meantime, there are flooding concerns also towards central Washington. Rising floodwaters threatening a century-old dam near Leavenworth. Homeowners downstream and are now being told to be prepared to evacuate at a moment's notice. The 8 Mile Lake Dam was built in the 1920s, made of dirt, rock, and mortar. High water already causing some minor damage at different portions of the dam, and about 50 homes are in jeopardy downstream right now. Chelan County Emergency Management met last night. They're making up a game plan on what to do if that dam fails, so we'll keep an eye on it for sure. For now, Tom and Jane, back to you.